Okay, we're here in Budapest in a massive demonstration against the government. We're expecting 100,000 plus people in Budapest, and there's a solidarity demo in London, in Dublin, Paris, Berlin, apparently in Malta, and there's probably more, but this is as much as I've been informed of. The Prime Minister has escaped from the country, he's gone to Italy, to Milan, for some reason. So this is the Octagon, it's an intersection that this is like the 8th or the 9th time that it gets shut down and occupied by protesters. It's a new culture, yeah. So after 6 or 7 years people started to learn the non-violent toolkit of change making and how to occupy spaces and how to do flash mobs and all. So this is like a mixture of three methods. To take the square and the British reclaim the streets. And the third one is like the Nuit Debout, the French Nuit Debout, because this is happening at night. It's shutting down an intersection, so it's not like taking the square, because it's not a square. But it is called Occupy Octagon. So you can see there's a nice little rig in the middle. That's the rig that was also cleared from the two-tailed dog party squandering fund, so it can be mobilized anytime it's needed. There was a rock band playing on this thing, and now it's playing music until the morning, basically. So we're gonna have a little street party until the morning. If it was Sunday, then we could stay a bit longer and block the traffic, but on Sunday morning, because this is Saturday night now, it doesn't make too much sense, so it's probably going to clear up by the morning, but it does provide a space for people who are still coming from Parliament to meet up and hang out Saturday night, and it's still a direct action, so this is kind of a mischievous occupation style street party, and the 8th or the 9th one so far. So that's it, Occupy Octagon, Hungarian Spring 2018, Budapest. Hopefully this is a milestone in democracy on the east end of Europe.